bull fight. 39-year-old Gary Nold from Downpatrick in Northern Ireland against Joseph Mukasa of Uganda for the WKN Pro-Am World Superweight title. Mukasa's fight record, 25 contests, 24 wins, and just one defeat. He's a really tough opponent for Nold. Mukasa's fought in Belfast before, twice, and twice he's won by knockouts. But Gary Nold knows what he's doing too. Fight record, 18 fights, 16 wins, one draw, and just one defeat. Rarely has a fighter ever been so determined to succeed in a sport. Nold is so single-minded, he just wants this world title. Last time out, it was Matt Carles, the Canadian fighter, who felt the power of the Nold punching. That was just 6 weeks ago when Nold won the Intercontinental title with a devastating display of punching. Another performance like that will surely make Nold world champion, but Mukasa will have his own ideas about that. Join us again after the break. It's world title time at the Ulster Hall in Belfast. Gary Nold from Downpatrick in Northern Ireland against Joseph Mukasa of Uganda. 7 2-minute rounds for the world pro-am super welterweight title. And straight away, Billy, Nold on the attack.
He is indeed. He's a big pressure fighter. Likes to come forward. Throwing hands and feet. Non-stop action from Gary Nold.
But he's one thing you can always rely on with Gary Nold, he's a 100% fighter. He'll go right to the end.
He gives Evans value for money. Got big, big support from Downpatrick here tonight.
The Ugandan, though, is a rangy, tall, stringy character, and he looks as though he could be a dangerous opponent.
He is indeed, Gary. He's a very strong kicker. As you said, he's been here in Northern Ireland twice before, and he's won both by the short route and by the kicks as well at that. A very dangerous body kicker.
Gary just needs to take his time to settle into this fight. He doesn't want to walk into a sucker punch or kick.
This will actually suit him well, staying on the inside like this. Mukasa will soon feel the power and he'll not want to be there.
Yes, I've seen Gary Nold in training and he has immense power, doesn't he? He really lashes the punches and kicks in.
And it must be said that he can take it as well.
Well, just as well, he took one there right on the chin, but it just didn't seem to faze him at all. Working away in the body now.
This will actually suit Gary, bringing it to the body. The body punches and bring it up to the head.
As he needs to get inside those long arms from Mukasa. This is going to be a good contest. Two different styles of fighter.
Just caught with a punch there, Gary. And another one straight through the middle.
Yes, that was good from Nold.
It must be said, this is one tough fighter, the Ugandan, Joseph Mukasa. It's an even round on my card.
I think you're right. Yes, fairly even. Let's have a look at some of the action again. Yeah, Mukasa got in there with a punch and a good kick to the ribs.
Very hard kicker. He soaked up a couple of right hands there.
Yes, he's talked about him having a good jaw. He can take a punch. It's just as well with this guy. Another punch right on the chin there. But it takes a lot to stop Gary Nold. What's the game plan for Nold here, Billy?
I think Gary needs to really stay on the inside. Continue with the pressure. If he stays on the outside, Mukasa will hurt him with the kicks to head and body. He's a lot longer, so it's easier for him to kick. and keep out of trouble from Gary Noel. He needs to stay on the inside and keep the pressure going.
Well, he was listening very intently to the instructions there in the corner, so let's hope it's good advice and that he can carry it out. Second round. Here we go. And right away, Mukasa's on the attack again. Those kicks actually, he's flicking them out, but they're playing some power.
He started the stronger here, Mukasa.
When he throws no, just keeps his head down and keeps pushing forward. There's a great sense of purpose about no.
Took a hard shot there to the body. And again. And again, three in a row. This is turning into a worthy title match.
Yes, and it's a match that is really giving Gary Noad something to think about. The Ugandan is really coming at him now. Good kicking.
Gary will need to keep his elbows in tight.
Oh, nice shot. Absolute cracker. That has hurt Mukasa.
He's under pressure here, Gary.
He doesn't know where he is. Oh, this could be all over very, very early. This could be another quick end to the fight. Caught him again. He's all over the place, but he's fighting back. Give him credit.
He caught again with a left hook. Ugandan's in a little bit of trouble and distress.
He's surely not going to see the end of the round, is he?
This is fabulous work. This is exactly what he needs to do. Keep coming forward. Keep the pressure going.
I think if Noel can just hit him again, this fight could be gone. Gary's not rushing into anything. He maybe has lost the opportunity here for an early finish. He certainly had the Ugandan wobbling, but end of the round.
Give Joseph Mukasa some credit there. He took those shots really well.
He did well to survive the round. Just look at this.
Oh, tremendous left hook.
There can't be many fighters who could take that sort of punishment and see the end of the round out.
Excellent work from Noad. Just seized the moment, kept the pressure on, and just kept with his man. That's a big round for him, this one.
That was a huge round.
He needs to be careful with those kicks, though.
It's just remind us, Billy, how many kicks do we need to get away in this fight?
8 kicks per round, mandatory. If you fail to get the kicks off per round, you lose a half point per kick. Do it over 2 rounds and you're disqualified.
Well, they're working hard in the Mukasa corner there, but all seems quiet in the Noad camp. I think they took a lot of encouragement out of that second round.
That was a big round. On my card, it was a 10-9 round, so Gary's well in front.
Now here we go for round 3. Mukasa a little bit slow to come out of the corner. And Noad's going hunting again. Now let's see what they can produce this time.
This is exactly where he wants to be. Not out there, but back in the inside.
If Noad's punching to the ribs, must be taking a toll on Mukasa now.
And the answer's back.
Yes,
here he comes.
Ugandan's coming back again. Noad has to be careful. This is a dangerous opponent. And I don't think stamina is going to be an issue for Noad. He trains so hard and he just wants it so much, doesn't he?
He's never out of the gym. He trains 6 days a week. He's got a really physical job at that. He's a builder. So he's lifting all day, he's very strong. This fight's at super welterweight. He won the intercontinental title fight at welterweight and he's come up to challenge Joseph Mukasa for the super welterweight. We were a bit concerned about the power, but as we can see, he's brought the power with him to super welterweight.
Yes, and I think he definitely hurt Mukasa there. Oh, nice spinning move there. Didn't do any damage, but it looked good.
Very dangerous technique, the spinning back fist. No, just keeps coming at him, doesn't he? And you can hear what they think of him in Belfast. The crowd is really behind our man now. He's got a terrific following here.
Oh, that looked as if it hurt.
Just at the end there, Ugandan was starting to hold a little bit more. I thought Gary should have just put a little bit more pressure on. But look at these kicks and punches.
Yes, those definitely are hurting, Node. When he swings those long legs, he gets a lot of impact into the kicks.
It's a good job that didn't hit. Spinning back fist. We saw what it can do earlier when Sean Collier was on the deck with one.
And there's the spoiling. Node's trying to work inside, but he's not really getting anywhere. Casa holding on there. I just wonder if he's starting to feel the pace of it. A bit more relaxed in the corner this time.
Well, I think they took their time to sit their man down. He's been standing there for nearly 40 seconds.
You think he should have been taking a
rest?
Yeah,
he should have took the rest. Never mind the bravado standing in the corner, take the rest when you're giving it. Macassa's starting to look a little bit weary, I think. Just as I say that, he does a jump roundhouse kick.
These are two tough guys. They really are. They're good opponents for each other.
There's a cracking punch Node just took on the chin. And again.
Doesn't seem to make any difference, Billy. Node just keeps coming at him. No matter what the Ugandan throws, it must be very disheartening for a fighter when you throw a good shot like that and it has no visible effect.
That's just his style. He's such a tough man.
That's a slip, isn't it?
Yeah. That's no knockdown. Just a little bit off balance. Throughout all his young career, I must say, he's just 4 years into the kickboxing and now he's fighting for a world title. But right from the start, he's been a pressure fighter.
This is a latecomer to kickboxing. Oh yes, that was a good punch.
That definitely hurt Mukasa.
I think so. He's stuck in
another
corner.
One.
He needs to get away from there.
Holding on. Distress signals.
Yes.
And?
Not happy.
It's over.
Well, that's remarkable. That came about just so suddenly.
I think it was a straight right hand, Gary, that just took the life straight out of the Ugandan. And he was not denied. World champion.
And here we go. That's the one that finished the fight. But I think all the hard work earlier on has finally paid off. It wasn't just that one big punch that did it.
Great sportsmanship, as ever.
That's always nice to see.
Tremendous work. There was his distress signals coming in from Mukasa to his corner.
Yeah, he just didn't want to go on. He'd had enough there, hadn't he?
He just wore him down, broke his heart, and finally, the big punch at the end just sealed it. What a shot, right straight through the middle.
Yes, every fighter wants to produce one like that, and Gary Node has done it. Here's the official announcement. Fans love it, and here comes the moment that Gary Node has trained so hard for, fought so hard for. Gary Node, world champion. It's always good to see the respect from two fighters.
Gary Node, world champion. How does that sound?
That's got just a ring to it there, Gary. That's beautiful.
Looked as though you were going to do it the easy way in the second round, and suddenly it didn't become quite so easy, did it?
Hit me somewhere off hard. That's the hardest I've ever been kicked. We're really bang, right on the money. He winded me on the second, he didn't realise it, but give me time to get sucked up when I got back to my corner. But I don't know why he seemed to just give up there, but I think I've damaged my knuckle here. Because I caught him with a right cross, and that was one hard punch. I think I've done a bit of damage, maybe a snow or something. But
you seem to be picking him off with the right hand quite a lot.
Yeah, but he was good to keep me out, mate. I like to get in close. He was good to keep me out. He's strong, powerful kicker. But
yeah, he threw a lot of kicks at you, didn't he?
A lot of kicks. I knew his power was going to be in his kicks, and mine was going to be in my hands. So obviously he's going to try and keep me and load up, keep me on the outside. And he was doing a good job there for a while, but I caught up with him in the end.
The 3 years from starting kickboxing to becoming world champion has been quite a ride, hasn't it?
Definitely, guy. It's unreal, honestly. They told me a couple of years ago. I'd have said no. I thought, no, one or two, get a few fights, see how it goes. But it just kept going from strength to strength.
Bit of celebrating to do tonight, yeah?
Definitely.
I'll let you get on with it.
Thanks very much, guy. Thank you.
Well done.
Good man.
Go, Gary, was the message from the fans. And go, he certainly did. A great night for the fans, a great night for Gary Knowd, great night for kickboxing. And isn't that lovely to see, just moments after getting out of the ring, deceived by youngsters wanting his autograph, and he's got a moment for every one of them. So that's it from the Ulster Hall, where the action was short, sharp and explosive. Thanks to the sponsors, Belfast City Council, the Holiday Inn and the Sunday People. And until next time, goodbye. And Downpatrick's Gary Knowd had to do it the hard way as he battled with England's Sean James, both fighters giving everything, but Knowd getting the decision to win the European welterweight title at the age of 38. Fighters from Thailand won two of the world titles being contested.
...gloves after one final fight in Belfast next month. Both he and fellow world champion Gary Hamilton were in action in Spain at the weekend, but as Gary Gillespie reports, both ended up on the losing side.
Northern Ireland's two top kickboxers travelled to Barcelona for non-title fights. For Gary Knowd, there was a change of style as he switched disciplines to fight under Muay Thai rules, which allow full contact using elbows and knees as well as kicks and punches. He described it afterwards as the difference between playing football and then switching to rugby. Knowd took the fight to his Spanish opponent and went the distance in spite of taking heavy punishment throughout the five-round contest. But it was no surprise when the judges gave the decision to the technically superior Spaniard. Now Knowd has decided to fight just once more in front of his home fans in the Ulster Hall next month before hanging up his gloves for good. Stablemate Gary Hamilton moved up two weight divisions to take on another Spanish opponent, Oscar Biel. Hamilton rocked the Spaniard in the early rounds, but the move from featherweight to light welterweight was too much, and eventually Biel's weight advantage began to tell. He put together a series of kicks and punches in the fourth round before unleashing an unstoppable left kick, which dropped the Ulsterman to the canvas. Now Hamilton is determined to get back to winning ways in front of the Belfast fans at what they're calling the Kickmas Box in the Ulster Hall.
between introducing firstly in the blue corner, coming from Portugal, he holds a 16-5 record, 12 wins, 4 losses, 2 wins by way of knockout. Please welcome to Belfast, Dario Teixeira. Old opponent across the ring in the red corner. From here in Downpatrick, Northern Ireland, holding a 19-fight record, 17 wins, 1 loss and 1 draw, 7 wins coming by way of knockout. He's an Irish, British, European, Intercontinental and World Amateur title holder. Please welcome Downpatrick, Skelly Knowles!
Well, I left the proceedings to our MC tonight,
above and below the waist,
but you're looking at Dario Teixeira from Portugal, and Gary Knode, Downpatrick, Northern Ireland.
7 2-minute rounds of full contact for the welterweight championship of the world.
Well, Gary Knode looks as if he's up for this. 39 years of age. 19 fights, 17 wins, 1 loss, 7 KOs. He's the Irish, British, European, Intercontinental and World Amateur title holder. But Dario Teixeira of Portugal, the younger man at 24, 16 fights, 12 wins, 4 losses and 2 KOs. Dario Teixeira in the red trunks against Downpatrick's Gary Knode in the blue trunks. Well, we saw Knode fight a couple of weeks ago here on British Eurosport, and he did a lovely demolition job then. Let's see what he offers up tonight against his opponent, Teixeira. Well, Knode, the hungrier of the two fighters, putting pressure on early on in this bout. And the age differential here would suggest to you that, well, Teixeira would have a huge advantage against the 39-year-old Knode, but in actual fact that's not the case, because Gary Knode is fired up here tonight and looking to do some damage. Quite clearly, at 39 he's not looking to do any overtime, so wanting to finish this quick, and he's got that look about him, and that looked as if it could have been the one. Oh, and it was! That left went straight over the guard of the Portuguese fighter, Gary Knode. Rings the doorbell. Teixeira answered, and in went Gary Knode's delivery in the shape of a cruelly telling straight left hand. There it is. There it is. Rocked Teixeira's head right back over the ropes. So fast and hard was the punch that the Portuguese fighter on the rebound couldn't even be caught by Knode.
Oh yes, big start.
Well, at 24 years of age, that's going to start to have a psychological effect. Knode, of course, trained by Billy Murray. We saw his last fight where he beat Uganda's Joseph Mukasa for the WKN full contact super welterweight world title. Well, Teixeira back in for the second. looking sprightly. But is the writing on the wall? Well, no sooner said than done. Gary Knowd, sensing that he can finish this early, does the business full fat style. And yes, it's another withdrawal. And I think the referee has intervened, and rightly so. Teixeira was only going to face more grueling punishment, more of the same. So Knowd.
Thank you very much.
Without a doubt, superb performance, very focused, very deliberate. Searching for that chin every time, and that was a cracker. Knocked the sweat off Teixeira's head.
Here we go, just the contest. This one, Gary Knowd from Belfast, 50 wins out of 75 as an amateur, 40 years of age now, twice an Ulster champion, twice an All-Ireland champion, in action against Richard Brooks here, who's won two and lost two. Decent little fighter, Richard, by the way. And I suspect his problem here against Gary Knowd is that Gary's probably a pretty decent all-rounder. Well, as we can see here, a nice fast-handed boxer. Probably a pretty decent puncher as well. That left hook there from Knowd. But Richard Brook, with his dad in his corner, will be absolutely fired up for this one. He wants a win. And once again, nice bit of work here from these two. Well, Richard Brook's coming on strongly here. Takes a nice little short left hook there, though, from Gary Node. Very fast hands, Gary, hasn't he? Well, he's a decent little fighter, Gary Node. No doubt about that. 40 years of age, remember, and a very athletic individual. And Richard Brooks, well, he's never in a bad fight, Richard, that's for certain. But of course, the problem he has here, oh, nice right there from Node. He's dealing with the speed of punch here, and of course the variety. Gets through there, a decent right there, Richard Brook. Brooks, I'm sorry. And it's been a real tear up this opening session. Lots of good work done by these two, and particularly, of course, from Gary. Oh, once again, Richard Brooks there, just chucking that right hand in a little bit of speculation, but it is getting through on target. Not a great deal in this opening session. The speed of punch from Node has really made a huge difference, because he's landed plenty of them. But Richard has done his fair share of the work as well. Well, is there a cut? Is there a cut? I think there is, on or under the left eye here of Gary Node. And that might mean a danger signal here for Richard Brooks. Node may suspect that he's got to get rid of him sooner rather than later. Don't think it's a bad one, otherwise it wouldn't be continuing at this stage. But there's no doubt about it that Gary Node has got ability and wins the first round, although I've got to say a decent effort there from Richard Brooks. Into round two we go then, and Gary Node cut by the left eye, but won the first round, never comfortably, because Richard Brooks was always there, always happy to swap that right hand. And Richard's never ever bigger than his opponent, and that's a major disadvantage as far as I'm concerned. I do know he loves his boxing, he likes competing, but sometimes, you know, you just want to go in there on an even playing field, and I don't think he gets that all the time. And again, nice start here from Gary Node. Well, once again, lovely fast punches these from Node, and good variety too. But Brooks, well, he's a never say die character. And he's giving Gary Node here as much as he can handle. Tough guy, Richard. Had a draw, by the way, in Wales in Cardiff with Sean McKee, who's standing just over to my left, taking a big interest in this. They'll probably get it on again, I suspect. Well, Richard Brooks now really trying to pile on the pressure here in round two. Oh, nice left hook there from Richard. Oh, and a good right hand there from Brooks. Not much in this round, is there, really? Richard certainly deserves a share of this one. Well, nice little right to the body there from Brooks. And it's still very hard to pick between them in this second round. And I'm going to call that round level. I hope no one minds.
I've got a short.
Good to see you, Charlie. Here we go then, this is the third and final round of the side, this one. Gary Node from Belfast. Great first round, and Richard Brooks came back and had a good second, in as much as I think he shared it, and he could get a draw out of this with a good finish. But I suspected that Node won't allow him to. Gary, of course, cut in the first. And what's happened here? Gum shoulder's gone there from Richard Brooks. It'll have to be washed and replaced. I would show you his dad, but he's a little bit too small to see, unfortunately. I don't mean it, Dad. Well, an awful lot of movement on the stage here, which is a bit of a shame. Well, no, doing the right thing now. Trying to keep a bit of distance here and just boxing at long range. Richard Brooks, on the other hand, of course, he knows he needs to get in close here and make a difference. Oh, a good couple, lovely punch swapping from these two lads. Terrific stuff. Well, Brooks now beginning to close him down here in this third and final round, and what a war we've got on our hands here. Terrific stuff. Well done. And this is the best I've seen Richard Brooks, by the way. Really has improved. That's right there from Node. Gumshoe's gone again, and that's a major problem. It has to be washed and replaced, of course, in the event, for the safety of the boxer. What a great round this has been. Not much left, but also not much in it. Well, I've got a feeling that Gary Noe's going to win this one by a couple of points, and the moment really lovely right there from Brooks, from Richard, had a chance of getting back on level terms, but sadly this round has run away from him now. I say sadly for Richard, not for Gary, of course. Decent fighter. Obviously a pretty decent puncher as well. And again, nice clean shots here from Gary Node. Good win there. Cracking effort, though, from Richard Brooks. Well done, Rich.
Thank you. happened there, guys. Somewhat all lovely right there again from O'Reilly. Backing shot, and well, Gary knows here under a bit of pressure in this opening session. Now he's got a cut as well on the left eye, I think. Nice right there from Node, takes a good shot, comes back with a good one of his own. Well, I've got no idea what happened there on a technical level. Well, I do actually, but I'm not going to say anything. And there's a cut on the left eye here, I believe, of Gary Node's. And that's a cracking round. From what I saw of it, it looks like O'Reilly did enough to nick that first session. Here we go then, this is the second round of a scheduled three, and I'm so sorry about what happened in the opening session. I've got no idea. Well, I do, but I'm not going to name names. Charlie Albert, he tried, he failed. That's life. So, Gary Node then, 40 years of age, in the white shorts from Belfast, against a very decent kid here in Leo O'Reilly, who's undefeated in three, British light middleweight champion, of course. And I'll tell you what, a close first round, but O'Reilly won it. And Nodes is no fool, you know, three wins and one loss on his record, against a straight three wins, of course, for O'Reilly, looking for a family treble here. This is a hell of a round, just like the first was. O'Reilly is a very powerful young fella and likes to go forward at every opportunity, but knows they're coming back with a couple of decent shots of his own with a left hook particularly, although I've got to say it was blocked pretty successfully. Ooh. Well, typical O'Reilly stuff this, isn't it? Real back lad. Walks into a right hand though, and Nodes is no fool. Although it might be if he gets involved in the punch up here with Leo. Is a very decent fighter, but that's a good effort from Nodes. Although once again another round for O'Reilly there. O'Reilly, 25 years of age, from Gravesend, as I said, the light middleweight champion of Great Britain, and Nodes, 40, from Belfast. Here we go then, this is the third and final session.
Second out, third and final round.
So, Leo O'Reilly in the black shorts against Gary Nodes. And I'll tell you what, two decent kids, these. And if, against anyone else, you know, Nodes would be having a good time here. But against O'Reilly, of course, it's a different story. He's decent, don't get me wrong, Gary. And O'Reilly, ex-professional fighter, and a good one. Nice left hook. Heavy punches these, and Nodes again takes them very well. Yep, younger brother Casey and Jono both won earlier on, so family treble coming up now here for Leo O'Reilly. But he's been put through his paces here, I think, by Notes. Good work here from Gary. He might just be winning this final session. Oh, punch and left hook there from O'Reilly. Very game, these two, aren't they? What a great way to finish the show. Terrific stuff. And Nodes firing back exceptionally well. I think on the strength of the first and second rounds, O'Reilly will win this, but I tell you what, he has been put through his paces. Of that, there is no doubt. Good fight. Let's see this one go on again. Good finish here for Gary, the Irishman. That's a little cracker. Well done, boys. Well done. Well done. And O'Reilly gets the win.
Thank you very much indeed. Good night.